Now, I can understand your dilemma. You want to get your first credit card, but you have no credit score. It's just like trying to get your first job without any job experience. Why would somebody want to hire you? Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Brennan here, back at you with another video. So today, guys, we're going to be going over getting your first credit card, how to do it, and why it is so important. Now, I can understand if maybe you're a little bit skeptical about getting your first credit card. I know that I was, because a lot of people in my family shun it. It's like, oh, credit cards are so bad, they're evil, because it's very easy to get in debt if you are not controlled with your spending on your credit card. The whole point of getting your first credit card is to build your credit score, and you don't have to lose any money at all in order to build your credit score. This credit score then allows you to get better interest rates on your first home or a car or anything that you want to get in which you are borrowing money. Now, when you're choosing your first credit card, there are a variety of different options and different variables that can affect your ability to get your first card. Now, personally, I had zero, a completely undefined credit score, so I'm starting out with literally nothing to my name. However, there are different factors and contributing of things that can affect your ability to get your first credit card and will help you definitely get started with that as well. And those contributing factors are your income, any kind of rent payments, any money being sent to you directly, as well as if you are a college student, that can also affect your ability to get approved. Now, the best option for someone getting started would either be a secured credit card where you have to put down a $300 to $500 security deposit, or a entry-level card such as a college card or something similar to that. So like I said, those contributing factors can really help you out a lot. The first card that I ended up getting approved for is a Wells Fargo cashback college card. So that is the one that I currently have and what I am using now to start building out my credit score. So I would recommend that for a lot of you guys, because they basically just assume, okay, yeah, you are living as a dependent person or whatnot. You're set up in a scenario where you can start building out your credit because they trust that you have income, that you have, you know, some sort of financial aid potentially, or you're a college student. All those kind of contributing factors can definitely help you. Or if you're even lower than that, you could also get just the secured credit card. That is so that they have collateral against you with that security deposit. That is another option for you. Now, obviously, there's a variety of different cards as well. Those are just the couple that I have seen personally. You definitely have to do your own research to see what works for you, but that is how I was able to get approved relatively quickly. Now, the thing to keep in mind with credit cards, and I stress this to absolutely everyone wanting to get their first credit card, is that you must spend responsibly. If you don't spend responsibly and you pay off your bill every single time at the end of the month, you're going to end up impacting your credit score negatively, and that will hurt you. You want to make sure that you pay off anything that you charge on your card at the end of the month when it is due and pay it off in full. This is going to allow you to prove to the credit card companies and the credit bureaus that you are a secure person, that you know what you're doing with your money, and that you can pay back your bills on time. And building out your credit score is super, super important, because without this, you're not going to be able to get approved for any kind of car loan or any kind of house loan at all that you want to get in the future, no matter how high your income is. If you're making a ton of money, it still does not matter to any of these companies. They want to see that you have a good credit score, that you can pay back bills on time, and that you're consistent and repeatable and trustworthy. Now, another factor to keep in mind as well is your total usage of your credit limit. On this first card, I only got a credit limit of $500, so quite low. However, I'm only going to spend maybe a couple dollars. Maybe I buy a McChicken at McDonald's just to have a charge on the account, and then I pay it off at the end of the month. Even if it's just a couple dollars, that is what I will put on the credit card so that it shows that I am able to pay off the bill on time. It doesn't have to be a lot of money. You want to keep your total usage percentage, which is basically just the amount that you spend out of your total credit limit, very, very low, because low credit usage also impacts your score and it definitely helps you increase it. So that's what I will be doing. That's what I recommend to you guys as well, is to just buy a McChicken or something like that. Something small, something like groceries, you know, something that you're not putting a lot of charges on it, because if they see that you're using up almost all that $500, even if you pay it off, you're still using a high amount of your credit. So you want to just use a teeny, teeny bit, maybe like 5 to 10%. Really, I think relatively under 30% is what they look for. So spend under 30%, even as low as you can really get on that total credit limit that you were allotted, because most people, when they're getting started, they only get like a $500 limit because they don't have a lot of trust in you yet, or you might even have a lower limit than that. So make sure that you're spending just a tiny bit of it, because that is going to help increase your credit score much, much faster. So if this video was helpful for those of you guys looking to get your first credit card, these are definitely some of the best tips that I have to get approved for your first card and start building out your credit score. If you like the video, please be sure to smash that like button. If you want to see more videos about marketing, business, and personal finance, all that kind of fun stuff, be sure to hit the subscribe button, hit that notification bell as well, so you don't miss anything. But anyway, guys, that's all for today's video. So I will see you in the next one. Peace out.